Hi, today I want to show you a DIY NAS server from old PC. I looked for used components on a website and after a long negotiation with the seller I managed to buy motherboard, CPU, RAM and power supply for 35 euros, about $35. The CPU is an AMD A4 5300 socket FM2 APU at 3.4 GHz, and very low power consumption. The motherboard is an Asus F2A85 M with 7 SATA ports, 2 pci-e 16 slots, 1 pci-e 1 slot, and 1 pci slot. The integrated network card is 1 gigabit per second. I am going to replace the original CPU cooler with the CPU cooler of an AMD FX8350 for better performance and temperatures. The fan is also bigger and less noisy. Now I am going to disassemble the old CPU cooler, clean the CPU, spread the excellent Noctua NTH1 thermal paste, and mount the larger CPU cooler. The M3 Plus CPU cooler fits perfect in FM2 socket. To spread the thermal paste, I use the finger technique. The RAM are two banks, one 4 GB and one 2 GB DDR3, which I will increase in the future. Now, I will clean the video card, and change the thermal paste. Again, I will use Noctua NTH1 thermal paste. The video card is a low power consumption, NVIDIA GT210. The power supply is an old 500-watt cooler master, that is working fine for the moment. The case is an old cooler master, that I had in the garage for years, among the dust. The case supports micro-atx motherboards, but there is really a lot of space for disks. In fact, with simple modifications, I could easily mount up to 8 hard drives. The hard drives are 6 Seagate 2.5-inch 5400 revolutions per minute drives. Performance is good, and power consumption is very low. The drives are all the same, and I will be able to make a RaidZ in TrueNAS. To decrease the vibration and noise of the discs, I am going to use an adhesive rubber, that is usually used in motorcycle fairings. This rubber, I will install between the case and the hard drives, which I will then screw on. Since I wanted to build very cheap NAS, I am going to install the TrueNAS operating system, in a 16 GB used micro SD card from smartphone, connected to the internal USB port via adapter. I also added a hot swap tray for 3.5 inch hard drives, if I were to make automatic backups, to a drive that I would be removing. I chose to install TrueNAS Core. The disks are configured in RaidZ 1, so with the possibility of one disk failure, I will only need the NAS for file sharing between multiple computers and will not use virtual machines. The NAS seems to work very well, is quiet and consumes little power. This DIY NAS in total it cost me $35, using used parts from old PC. I already had the disks, because they were removed from old laptops, upgraded to SSD. I think I got a good deal, for a 7 hard drive, micro-atx format, quiet and low power consumption NAS. What do you think? Write it in the comments and see you in next videos, and please subscribe.